This is the solution to written homework 66. Okay. So for this one, first step is that, so the outer integral is from 0 to 2. The inner integral is with respect to x, so we'll do that now. So that's x cubed over 3 plus xy, since y is constant with respect to x, and then this is evaluated from x is 0 to x is 3y dy. So integral 0 to 2, plugging in 3y. So 3y all cubed is 27y cubed, and then that's over 3, plus plugging in 3y, that'd be 3y squared, and then minus 0 dy. So that is integral 0 to 2. 27 over 3 is 9, so that's 9y cubed plus 3y squared dy. Using the fundamental theorem, that would be 9 over 4y to 4 plus y cubed, and then this is evaluated from 0 to 2. So that would be 9 over 4 times 16 plus 8, and then minus 0, because that's what you get when you plug in y is 0. 16 over 4 is 4 times 9 is 36. So that would be 36 plus 8. So that's 44. Okay, that's the answer to part A. For part B, let's consider. So you're given a hint that one of the orders is easier than the other. So this right here, this is a double integral. But according to Frobenius, this double integral is the same as the two different iterated integrals. So really what we need to consider is which would be easier to start with. So which is easier to start with? This one, if we were to start with x's, so 2 x cubed exponential x squared y dx. Or this one, 2 x cubed exponential x squared y dy. Well, this could be done. This could be done could be done with about 3 integration by parts. So we could use integration by parts. We need to do it twice. So twice would suffice, actually. I'll just say multiple. I'll put a question mark to hedge my bets. Whereas this one, as complicated as it looks, all those x's are actually constant, so 2x cubed can be factored out and ignored, and x squared is just a constant. So this one could be done with the antiderivative of exponential of ky dy is exponential of ky over k plus a constant. So of those possibilities, it's easier to start with the y's. So we like this one. So this is the good one. And this one is perhaps possible, but might bring tears. So we'll do integral with the x's on the outside and the y's on the inside. So 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 2x cubed, exponential, x squared y, dy, dx. And I'll wall off some space for me here. In case I need it. So this would be integral 0 to 1 of, well, that'd be 2x cubed, because that's just a constant, and then multiplied by the exponential of x squared y, and then over x squared, and then all of this must be evaluated from y is 0 to y is 1 dx. Okay, so now we can simplify a little bit. This would be 0 to 1, and then 2x because the x cubed over x squared cancels, 2x exponential x squared y. Evaluated from y is 0 to y is 1 dx. So at y is 1, that is 2x times the exponential of x squared at y is 1, and then minus at y is 0, that's the exponential of 0, which is 1, so minus 2x, like so, dx. Now, for this one, I'll do a little substitution in my head. I can see that if u is x squared, then du is 2x dx, which is present right there. So as a result, I can see that this would be exponential of x squared, and then, because that's the antiderivative of the first term, minus x squared, because that's the antiderivative of 2x, and now evaluated from 0 to 1. So that would be e to 1 minus 1, and then minus e to 0 minus 0. So the exponential of 0 is 1, so this is e minus 2.